How do you mix strings in a realistic orchestral mockup? In this video, I will show you my workflow. Hi there, this is David, also known as Ghostwriter. I'm a Dutch media composer, and on my channel, you can listen to my music and watch videos about how to write orchestral music for film and video. So if you want to get better in that, in orchestration, in creating more realistic orchestral mockups, then start now by subscribing and clicking that little bell. So let's continue where we left off last week. And we're in Logic again, watching at the mixing template. And if you have followed me along, it should look something similar like this. And last week I was talking about three plugins which I have used on my master bus. One is the Voxengo Span, the other one is the Isotope Insight plugin, which is a really awesome plugin, and the Isotope Imager, which I used to put my track in mono, because you always want to mix your tracks in mono. But this week we are concentrating on how to mix strings in a realistic orchestral mockup. So I'm going to talk about long strings and mixing short strings. As you can see, I'm only using four plugins on each single track. And normally you want to route those plugins to certain buses. But for the simplicity of this masterclass, I'm not going to talk about buses and routing and using plugins in that structure. I just want to show you what kind of plugins I use to mix orchestral music, strings in this case. And there are four plugins which I have used on each single string track. One of them is the FedFX plugin, which is a stock plugin from Logic Pro X, and I will tell you in a minute why I use it, what the function is of this plugin. The second plugin that is on each single track is this one. This is the AP550A equalizer plugin, which I use to fine-tune some of the EQing of the instruments. The other one is from Waves, which is the S1 Imager. This plugin creates some width in your mix. And the last plugin which I have used on each track is this one, which is the Spaces 2 from East West. This is a reverb plugin which I use to position my instruments within this orchestral mockup in a certain room, in a certain space. All right, so let's continue by talking about each plugin in a little bit more detail and tell you why I use it and how I use it. Oh yeah, one more thing. Well, you have to realize that the effect of these plugins on a single track can be quite small. That is not a bad thing, because when you are listening to all the strings together and all those tiny differences that you created on the single track will have a bigger, sometimes a huge effect on the total sound of all the strings, of the sound of the total track. So realize that some of the effects are hard to notice on the single track, but will create a huge effect, a bigger effect on all the tracks together, when you listen to all the tracks together. So let's listen to the first track. I already selected one, which is the violin long, and I've put a loop on it. And let's listen to this part with all the plugins turned off. So this is just the sound as it comes out of the library. Which already sounds pretty nice. Alright, and so on. Alright, let's add the first plugin, turn on the first plugin, which is the FedFX. I will flip it on, I will flip it off, I will flip it on, and listen to it with your headphones on. So there we go. It's turned off right now, and I flip it on somewhere. Thank you. Right, there's a tiny difference, and the thing that this plugin does is add some, let's say, some warmth, some analog flavor to the sound of the strings. And that is the reason why I use this plugin, which is a stock plugin from Logic Pro X. And as you can see from this plugin, I only have the distortion and the bass enhancer turned on. The rest is all turned off. And I use a little bit of the soft saturation, only 22%, and a little bit of the very drive, 21%, and the bass enhancer. And with a 63% mix of it, and the output is 6 dB minus with some soft limiting. That's the only thing that I use, and this is really, really, really subtle. Really subtle. It is to create a little bit more of an analog flavor, a little bit warmth that we all love from the old days, the some sort of tape vintage sound, the warm sound, the real sound. That's why I use this plugin, and I use it on all the strings, single tracks from the strings, with the same, with all the same settings like I just showed you. If you don't own Logic Pro X, just find one of your favorite analog flavor kind of plugins. You also can use NLS. This is this one. I use that a lot also for the strings with the Nevo. So if you don't have the FedFX plugin and you own the NLS plugin, which is also from Waves, then you can use that on the Nevo setting, and you will get a similar effect. All right, the next plugin is a equalizer plugin, and that's this one, the AP550A, also from, which you can also buy at Waves. And let's start this single track again and listen to it with the plugin turned off. And I will flip it on. And off. And again, the effect is really, really subtle. But if you listen to all the strings together, and we will do that at the end of this video, you will hear the difference of all these small changes. And these are the settings that I use for the high strings. I always plus it with 2 dB at the 10 kHz, minus 2 at the 1.5 kHz, and minus 2 at the 400. All right, then the S1 Imager, which I use to create a little bit more width in the mix. And let's listen to the track again. Now with the FedFX plugin turned on and the AP550, this one is still turned off. Let's turn it on. All right, and again, the effect is really, really subtle, but it's there. Believe me, it's there. The setting that I use is, I normally push it up to about 1.35, sometimes a little bit more, sometimes a little bit less for the high strings, and I will, and we will look at my settings for the other plugins, the short strings and the low strings too. All right, then we have the last one, the East-West Spaces. And again, let's listen to the track and I will turn this one on while we listen to it. And to hear the effect of the reverb, one little trick, and you should do this to check if you have enough reverb and you don't and you haven't added too much reverb to it, is to listen to the track with the reverb on and stop it and listen to the audio chill that the audio has. How long does it continue and does it sound realistic? So let's listen to it again from the start, and I will turn this plugin on and I will stop it and you will hear the reverb. Let's continue. I will turn it off and then you will notice the difference. Then it stops immediately. The reverb isn't there anymore. So that's the effect that you create with these East West Spaces 2 plugin. We're looking at the filter here. And I have turned it on. And this is an important thing that you need to do when you are using reverb, is to cut out the low frequencies, because you don't want the reverb on the low frequencies. So for the high strings, I've used a high pass filter around 500 hertz. Sometimes you can go even up higher, but just play around with it, listen to it, just stop the audio and listen to it if you have made a good cut at the low end. What I will do is I will upload a updated project file for a mixing template and will put in the settings that I have used for each of these plugins, knowing that the FedEffects plugin is the same for all the single tracks, that the EQ plugin has some differences between the high strings and the low strings, that the S1 imager is almost always the same for all the single tracks, and that we have differences by using the reverb plugin to position each instrument in a space and using a unique reverb chill for each instrument. Now, what I want to do is just select all the string tracks and listen to them with all the plugins turned on and with all the plugins turned off. And then you will hear the difference with the plugins and without the plugins. All right, so let's continue. And let's turn them off, all, and then add one, and listen to it. All right, there we go. Okay, we turn on the FedEffects for the analog flavor. All right, let's turn on the EQ plugin. Huge different. Again, let's turn it off. The EQ, let's turn the EQ off. Listen to it. This is without any manipulation of the EQ. And let's turn it on right now. Off. And on. It's a huge difference. All right, the S1 imager, they are all turned off, but let's turn it on again. All turned off. I definitely hear a lot of difference. I hope that you heard it too. And the last one, the reverb. They're all turned off. And let's start a loop again. And the reverb is on. Without. And on. And when you stop, you will hear the reverb tail. So these are the way that I mix strings in a realistic orchestral mockups, just using four plugins with really small little adjustments on each single track, but with a bigger effect when you are listening to them together. I hope that this video gave you some guidance about how to mix strings in a realistic orchestral mockup, and that it is about all the small, tiny little adjustments on each single track, which are hard to notice. But when you are listening to the tracks with all the tracks, with all the plugins, then you will hear the bigger effect, the huge effect that you had in mind when you started mixing your orchestral template. And that you don't make the same mistakes as I made when I started mixing orchestral music, that I was cranking up the EQ like hell on a single track to hear the difference, to add an enormous reverb tail on each single track because I wanted to hear the reverb on each single track, which made my mix eventually kind of messy and really, really, really bad. So keep in mind, it is all about the little adjustments on each single track. All right, next week I will be talking about mixing the woodwinds, the brass, and the percussion. I will do those together because I haven't used much plugins on these orchestral families. And I hope to see you next Thursday, next week. If you appreciate this video, smash that like button. Hit subscribe if you haven't done already. Ding that bell to get notified when I upload a new video. And I will see you next Thursday.